Hello friends, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video we will cover SAP HANA Studio. So first of all, what is SAP HANA Studio? So my SAP HANA Studio, it is an Eclipse based development and administration tool for working with HANA. So HANA Studio, it is a client tool, which means that we have to install it in our local, and it can be accessed local or the remote HANA systems. So we will install the HANA Studio into our machine, and using that we can access the local HANA system or the remote HANA systems. My HANA Studio, it will provide an environment for the administration, modeling and data provisioning. So we have different areas in SAP HANA, that is the administration and then the data modeling, which will come to the development of all the different views, and then the data provisioning. Data provisioning means that how we are bringing in the data from the different data sources into the SAP HANA system. So my SAP HANA Studio, it will basically provide me the environment for all these three. SAP HANA Studio, it can be used on the platforms like Microsoft Windows 32-bit and 64 version of the Windows XP, Vista, Windows 7, Linux, Enterprise Server. So all these platforms we can install the SAP HANA Studio. So on the right hand side of the screen, we can see that this is my SAP HANA Studio. So we can do the HANA administration, that is we can create the schemas, we can create the users, we can assign the privileges using the administration. After that we have the modeling. So in modeling, we can create the information views, we can define the structure of the data. So we can create the different types of views in SAP HANA, like attribute, analytical and calculation views. So all these, they come under the data modeling. After that, we have the data provisioning. So using SAP HANA Studio, we can get the data in SAP HANA database, like using the BODS, SLT or the direct data connection, that is my DXC. So these are the three different ways using which we can get in the data into the into the SAP HANA system. So when we add the system in the SAP HANA Studio, it will ask us for the port. So port 3615, it should be open to connect to the database. Port 31015, it should be the instance number 10. Port 30015 for the instance number 00, and the SSH port should also be open. So whenever we want to add the system into the SAP HANA Studio, so these are the few things which we have to keep in mind for the SAP HANA system. Thank you. So in this we have covered the overview of SAP HANA Studio.